Good morning. The clock doesn't lie. It's midday, so it's kind of still morning. Anyway, hello. I don't know when you're watching. You might not be watching on Monday morning. You could be watching any time. But welcome to the world of Girl and Duck. I'm Jen Storer, children's author and chief inspirationalist here at girlandduck.com. And this is my 20 tips series. And I've been doing this now, well, for 13 weeks, because today we're up to tip number 13. Duh, 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 duh. And all these tips are taken from my book, See Me Jump, 20 Things I've Learned About Writing Books for Children. And you can get this book, it's on print on demand over on Amazon, or you can get the PDF from my website, and I'll put all the links down below. So that you can do that if you want, you can get it. And because I expand on the tips in the book, obviously. But I'm late today, again, because this morning in the Duck Pond, which is our beautiful membership site for Kidlit creators, this morning we kicked off our masterclass series. So we had our first masterclass this morning. And I've got to tell you, it went off with a bang. Like, it was just beautiful. It was amazing. There were so many people there. It was live Q&A with Zanny Louise. So it was interactive class on Zoom. And it just went off with a bang. So it's been incredibly exciting. And if you're in the Duck Pond and you missed the live session this morning, that's okay, because it's recorded and we'll be posting it later in the units. In the group, in the Facebook group. And if you're thinking of joining the group, then hop over and have a look at the website and have a look at all the other presenters that we've got keyed up for the next few months. And we're busily working behind the scenes as well, getting other creators and other presenters lined up for the year, for sort of for 2021 as well. So we're ahead of the game here at girlandduck.com. So anyway, it's been a really, really exciting morning, and I'm just so grateful to Zanny Louise for doing the most exceptional job. Like, she just was amazing, and everyone's over there now going, oh, you know, posting and talking about the class and what they got out of it and all that kind of stuff. So this is what it's all about. It's about the community will pick you up and carry you along, you know. It's just a great thing. So I'm very, very happy. So. But let's go back to See Me Jump and tip number 13. Tip number 13 is kiss. Okay? Keep it simple, sweetheart. Now, again, this tip might seem to you to be a bit, you know, oh, well, you know, tell me something I don't know. It's extraordinary, actually. It's really surprising how many people don't know. They might know, you know, they might know it, but they don't sort of play it out in their work. Their work, they're writing for children, but it's convoluted and it's complex and the plot goes all over the place. And we need to remember, particularly when we're writing picture books, that that children's brains haven't developed yet. As I say in the book, they don't have enough noodles in their noodle. To be able to follow complex narrative structures. So as adults, what might seem and then and then and then and then is basically all kids can cope with at a certain age. And this can be hard for adults because we spend such a lot of time as adults trying to prove how smart we are. All right, let's face it, we do it. And then when we put things into writing, we're even more self-conscious, you know. We're even more anxious to impress with our intelligence. So it can be hard to drop that, to drop all that sort of pretense and get down to the child's level. So this can be really challenging for writers. And this is one of the arts of writing picture books, is being able to not only to keep it simple, but also keep it familiar in most cases. The world is brand new to them. I Saw a Frog is a friggin' book. You know, that is a monumental event in a child's life. I Did Up My Own Shoes is a monumental event in a child's life. So keep it simple and keep it familiar, which doesn't mean that you can't use rich and beautiful language. It doesn't. It just means that you have to avoid embellishing things, you know, that desire to embellish. Now, the other thing too that we need to keep an eye on is description. You know, we call them picture books for a reason. Picture book. We've got pictures. We've got illustrations. So we don't need to have a whole lot of drawn out, sometimes beautiful, lyrical description, because that can be painted via the illustrations. So yay, hey? Okay, hold on to that. That is a blessing. That's not a curse. It feels like a curse sometimes for writers who love words. But yeah, we need to keep the storyline simple and familiar and straightforward, and we need to resist the urge to embellish, and we need to resist the urge to put in complex description or waffling description. I'm just referring to the book here where I've talked about it. There's some examples in the actual book as well. But for today, I'm going to keep it simple. All right. I know that I start off this chapter two where I say, I think that anybody who sits down to write a picture book, the first thing they should write is a post-it note with KISS on it and stick it to their forehead to help them remember to keep it simple. All right. So that's tip number 13 from See Me Jump. I'll see you back here next week for tip number 14. Thanks for sticking with me and thanks for watching. Bye for now.